Hello, how are you today? Are you feeling fine? Well, as usual, I am very well, and I am very glad to be here again, helping you to learn English, to take you to new roads to English in high school. The first activity today is based on a video clip. You're going to watch a video clip to anticipate the topic of the lesson. So this is the first task of the lesson today. What is the topic of this lesson based on the video sequence? Okay? So in a few seconds, you are going to enjoy the video clip.
Number one, artificial brains. By 2045, neuroscientist Randall Kuna aims to create an artificial human brain. The concept of artificial intelligence isn't anything new. For decades, people have been fascinated by the idea that machines could have thoughts or emotions. While some find it amazing, others are terrified that we're pushing technology too far. They believe these robots may bring an end to humanity. But Kuna isn't worried about a mechanical revolution. Why? Well, because he says humans can digitally upload their brains. By merging with technology, Kuna claims humans will evolve into cybernetic organisms. Number two, humans on Mars. In 2024, SpaceX plans to send their first transport ship to Mars. While NASA estimates their first mission won't launch until after 2030, Elon Musk will send a cargo ship to Mars in 2022. A manned mission will then follow 2 years later. Musk's ship is called the Interplanetary Transport System, or ITS. Number three, lab-grown organs. Nearly 20 people die every single day waiting for an organ transplant. Trauma and disease often require entire body parts to be replaced. But really, there just aren't enough healthy organs for everyone. Luckily, artificial organs aren't too far off. From hearts to kidneys, scientists are working to grow functioning organs that can keep people alive for decades.
So, what is the topic of the lesson based on the video clip? Of course, I hope you have been able to anticipate the topic, that is, talking about future plans, future activities, all right? So it's talking about the future. That is the topic of the lesson today. Obviously, this is not a new topic because in secondary schools, you studied this content. But this time, we are going over the content. We are recalling the content of the lesson. So, ready to continue? Of course. The next activity will be also based on a presentation, right? But you're going to watch and listen to the explanation given by the presenter. But of course, you have a task. Let's see. And the task is, when do we use will and when do we use going to? You know that these two forms, we use them to speak about future plans, future activities, that is, to speak about the future. But you have specific tasks as you watch and listen to the video clip, okay? This is the activity you're going to do while you watch and listen to the video clip. So please copy. No, yeah, yeah. So, I think that you are ready now to watch and listen to the presentation about the forms we need to use when speaking about future activities. So enjoy the video clip.
Are you also facing problem with future? How to talk about your future plans? Then just relax. I'm here and I'm going to tell you how to talk about your future plans. What is the correct way of saying it? My name is Michelle. Join me in this lesson. Let's start. Talking about future plans, will and going to. Of course, as you would already know, will is one way to talk about future plans. I will go to the beach next Sunday. I will go to a restaurant this evening. This is used for future, according to what you know. Going to. I'm sure you're thinking it's present continuous, right? You're right. Of course you're right. It is present continuous. But this is present continuous used for future. Yes. Present continuous used for future. Used for future. But how really? Have you heard people saying, I'm going to the restaurant tomorrow or I'm going for a date tomorrow? You must have heard. I'll share an example with you. Once, one of my friend Harry, he called me, okay? Tring, 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 tring. Hello? Hi, Michelle. Hi, Harry. How are you? I'm fine, Michelle. How are you? I'm doing good, too. Michelle, would you like to join me for a coffee this evening? Yes, I will join you for a coffee this evening, but I need to tell my mom about it first. Pause. I will join you for a coffee this evening. I will join you for a coffee. I will join you for a coffee. How much time do you think I took for this decision? Did I ask him to wait? No. He asked me, would you like to join me for a coffee? And I said, yes, I will join you for a coffee. It was an instant decision. Yes, I hardly took any time to think about it. Very fast. So let's call it a rapid decision. Rapid decision. Are you thirsty? Yes. I will drink water. You're thirsty right now, so you will drink water that you've thought, and it's a rapid decision. You did not take any time for that. It was a quick decision. This decision is always made at the moment of speaking. For example, you're on call and you're thirsty. You're talking to your friend. How will you take a break? Hey, just hang on. I'll get a glass of water. I will has a short form, and that is I'll. This is always pronounced as I'll. I'll just get a glass of water. And as I told you, because it is a rapid decision, it is always made at the moment of speaking. Decision. At the moment of speaking.
Did you like it? Did you understand her explanation? Okay, I will help you to understand it in a better way. Okay? So let's look at the slide now. So how do we construct. How do we make the sentence? We have the subject. For instance, in this example, Amy will, plus the main verb. In this case, we have Amy will visit her grandmother tomorrow afternoon. Y ahora, mientras ustedes copian, yo quiero que ustedes analicen a partir de la información, de la explicación que les dio Michelle anteriormente. Quiere decir que Amy tenía la visita a su abuela planificada o la ha pensado en este momento. Evidentemente, la ha pensado en este momento, porque como ustedes apreciaron en la explicación que les dieron anteriormente, pues will se usa cuando se piensa, cuando se toma esa decisión en ese momento. Okay, are you ready to continue? Well, let's see, we are going to have practice, so you're going to do the following activity. So please, write these sentences. The sentences read, I will go to the, I will eat, I will go, I will study, I will play. So you are going to complete. Okay, ready? Let's go on. We have here other sentences. I will go there by, I will watch a, I will go to the, I will play, I will buy. So I will give you some seconds to copy. Bueno, ustedes se estarán preguntando, ¿pero con qué vamos a completar? ¿Cómo vamos a adivinar? Porque la palabra guess significa eso, ¿no? Adivinar. Entonces, ¿cómo lo van a hacer? You are going to do so by watching the next video clip. So please, watch, listen, and enjoy the video clip. Thank you. Was it difficult? I don't think so. But for those who were not able to complete all the sentences, well, here are all of them, right? So here you have the first part of the activity, the first five sentences, right? I will go to the park. I will eat pizza. I will go shopping. I will study math. I will play basketball, right? Just some seconds to complete the task if you were not able to do it before. The next part of the activity. I will go there by train. I will watch a movie. I will go to the beach. I will play soccer. I will buy a motorbike. Y ahora yo quiero que ustedes presten atención a un aspecto que vimos en la primera clase. Recuerden que en la primera clase nosotros adelantamos o explicamos algunas generalidades relacionadas con la variante americana y británica del inglés. Y entonces, si analizamos las oraciones 9 y la oración 7, ¿de qué variante del inglés estamos hablando? ¿Recuerdan? Vamos a ver, vamos a recordarlo. British or American English. ¿Qué ustedes piensan? Vamos a ver si acertaron. Esta fue una información que presentamos en la primera clase. British and American English. And so, in American English, we say soccer, the equivalent in British English to football, and in American English, we say movie, the equivalent to film in British English. Therefore, de esta manera, entonces, ¿de qué estamos hablando? ¿De qué variante representa este ejercicio que hicimos? The American variety of English. That's right. Ok, yo espero que ustedes hayan recordado esto. Vamos a continuar entonces con el tema principal de la clase de hoy, que es el futuro. All right? Talking about future plans. So, to continue recalling what you learned in secondary school about the forms to speak about future plans, my invitation is to watch and listen to Michelle in the next video clip. So please enjoy the video clip.
Now we come to going to. Shall we continue the conversation that we were having with Harry? How did I end that conversation? I told him that I need to tell my mom. So let me call my mother and inform her that I'm going to meet Harry. Tring, 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 tring. Hello. Hi, Mom. Hi, Michelle. How are you? I'm fine, Mom. I want to ask you something. Sure, Michelle. Tell me what you have to say. Mom, actually, I'm going for a coffee this evening with Harry. Is that fine? Yes, that's fine. You may go. Pause. What did I tell her? Either you can say for a coffee or I'm going to meet Harry this evening. That will also be fine. I'm going to meet Harry this evening. Here, when did I make the decision to meet Harry? I made it in the past, before the moment of speaking. I have already decided to meet Harry The arrangement has been made. The agreement has been made. Harry and I have discussed that we are meeting this evening. And then I'm telling my mom. So do you understand now that when we use going to, the decision was made before the moment of speaking. It's not an instant decision. You have the arrangements ready. The plan is ready. That is when you use going to. Decision made before the moment of speaking. Where are you spending your vacations? I'm spending my vacations in Hawaii. I'm going to spend my vacations in Hawaii? Yes. That is where we are using the future form of present continuous going to. But why did I say going to and not will? If I had not decided before this, if you ask me right now and I say I will spend my vacations in Hawaii, this means that I made the decision right now, and it was a rapid decision. But when I say I'm going to spend my vacations in Hawaii, that means the tickets are ready, the flight tickets are ready, the hotel is booked, the plan is sure, and we are going to Hawaii. Yes, that's what it means. It's not a rapid decision. It's a prepared plan. Prepared plan. I'm sure this must have helped you to understand the difference between will and going to. So you can use both of these with a in the future sense, but I would like to suggest you to remember that we use going to essentially with a future time marker. It's better. You can use it without any future time marker, which means that you're telling when you're going in the future. For example, I'm going to meet Harry this evening, so I'm also saying this evening. There are times when I may not say this evening, and it's understood. But if you add the future time, the listener will be able to understand you better. So you can say, I'm going to meet Harry this evening, or I'm going to Hawaii these summers. That'll help the listener to understand you much better. So please use these rules and do not worry about your future plans. It's simple and it's easy. Rapid decision, decision made before the moment of speaking. Very simple, isn't it?
Was it useful? Yes, of course, I think it was useful. Was it clear for you? Well, here we have the summary of the explanation given by the presenter. So please, copy. Will and going to. So this is some kind of summary. Remember, anteriormente, en la primera parte del video o antes de la primera parte de este video, pues yo les pedí que copiaran este cuadro para que mientras observaban el video, pues pudieran completar y seleccionar a qué estructura nos estábamos refiriendo. So, we use will with rapid decision, that is decision at the moment of speaking. Es decir, cuando se trata de una información, de una decisión que se toma en el momento en que hablamos, no es algo que sea planificado, que sea pensado con anterioridad. Sin embargo, en el caso de going to, lo hacemos con aquellas actividades que hemos planificado, que están anteriormente preparadas, ¿verdad? Pero eso no es exactamente así siempre. Por supuesto, el idioma tiene sus matices y quizás en estos momentos ustedes estén pensando, pero bueno, en un documental, en una película, en una serie de esas que ustedes generalmente pues les gusta ver, escucharon que no estaban hablando de una actividad muy planificada anteriormente y sin embargo, pues utilizaron uno u otra forma. Claro que sí, el idioma en su comunicación diaria, cotidiana, tiene estos matices, pero por lo general, gramaticalmente, en los libros, pues usted va a encontrar esta distinción. No obstante, en la comunicación, en la medida que no tenemos mucha práctica, pues lo importante es que cuando usted hable de algo que no está sucediendo en ese momento, es verdad, algo que tiene una proyección hacia el futuro, pues use una de estas, usted debe entonces usar una de estas dos posibilidades. Vamos a continuar ahora y entonces aquí tenemos cómo lo hicimos con Will, bueno, cómo se estructuraría esa oración. No le vamos a dar realmente mucho tiempo porque estamos rememorando contenidos que ustedes estudiaron en la secundaria básica o en experiencias de aprendizaje que tuvieron anteriormente. Just some seconds to copy. Okay, now it's time to practice. So, but before practicing, we have here the expressions of time. Ustedes recordarán que Michelle, en la presentación que ella hizo, les decía la importancia de las expresiones de tiempo. Bueno, para el futuro podemos utilizar this morning, this afternoon, this evening. Y ustedes dirán, pero bueno, this quiere decir ahora. Pero claro que estamos hablando de algo que va a suceder quizás hoy, pero un poco más adelante del momento exacto en que estamos hablando, ¿verdad? Y además tenemos otras expresiones como son, tomorrow, next, right? They also indicate future, ¿ok? Next, tomorrow, pero estas que vimos anteriormente se trata, bueno, pues cuando estamos tomando decisiones que van a ocurrir en unos momentos, ¿verdad? Entonces vamos a seguir con un poquito de actividad práctica. So let's copy the first, the fourth activity. Activity number four. Complete the sentences using going to or will. Ready? Here we have the three sentences. Please copy. And here we have the answers. So, sentence number one. My parents are going to give a present tonight. It's a promise. Tony is coming home to study tonight. Karen is going to bake a cake tomorrow. Now, she is very busy. Y noten la diferencia. La número uno, la número dos y la número tres. ¿Verdad? Is going to, is coming, are going to. En los tres casos, en estos tres casos, ¿de qué estamos hablando? De una actividad, por supuesto futura, pero que se ha decidido ahora mismo o que se ha planificado. Una actividad que se ha planificado, porque he utilizado going to, pero quizás ustedes utilizaron will o lo combinaron. Esta es mi propuesta, pero por supuesto La respuesta siempre va a depender de la intención de el que habla. Por eso, quizás en sus respuestas, bueno, pues ustedes utilizaron will. Pero recuerden que lo importante es tener en cuenta si lo hacemos planificado, si lo hemos pensado de forma planificada o si lo hemos tomado la decisión en ese momento. Ahora vamos a continuar con otra actividad. Ustedes van a ver en una interacción, en una conversación, cómo dos jóvenes hablan sobre los planes para el fin de semana.
Hi, Michaela. How's it going?
Oh, hi, Gemma. Fine, thanks. How are you?
Yeah, I'm good. Listen, it's Jack's birthday next week, and we're going to have a surprise celebration this weekend. Do you want to come with us?
Yeah, that would be great. What are you going to do?
Well, I'm not sure. Have you got any ideas?
How about going to the cinema?
Yeah, maybe. Are there any good films on at the moment?
There's that one comedy, Lucky Break.
Oh no, we saw that last week. It's really not that funny.
Oh, right. How about going ice skating?
Oh no, Jack doesn't like ice skating.
Well, what does he like?
Well, he likes bowling.
Yeah.
What about bowling?
That's a great idea. Everyone likes bowling.
Okay.
When should we go?
How about Saturday afternoon?
All right. Where should we meet?
Let's meet at the shopping centre, in front of the bowling place.
Okay. When should we meet?
3 o'clock.
Okay. That sounds great. So, Saturday afternoon, in front of the bowling place.
Yeah, it's a plan. I'll tell the others.
Cool.
Michaela, how's it going? I'm good. Listen, it's Jack's birthday next week, and we're going to have a surprise celebration this weekend. Do you want to come with us? Well, I'm not sure. Have you got any ideas? Yeah, maybe. Are there any good films on at the moment? Oh no, we saw that last week. It's really not that funny. No, Jack doesn't like ice skating. Well, he likes bowling. What about bowling? Okay. How about Saturday afternoon? Let's meet at the shopping center, in front of the bowling place. 3 o'clock? Yeah, it's a plan. I'll tell the others.
Okay, what are they planning? A birthday party or a surprise celebration? A surprise celebration, right. And whose birthday is it? It's Jack's, right. And Where are they going to celebrate? At the boiling place. Okay? At the boiling place. So, I think that that was a very interesting conversation between two teenagers. Así le decimos a los jóvenes que están en 15, 16, 17, teenagers. They are in their teens. And these two teenagers are organizing a surprise celebration. Una fiesta sorpresa para uno de sus compañeros. And before we summarize the lesson, I would like you to analyze these structures, all right? So, who is going, how is it going, okay? Y that would be great. That's a great idea. It's really not that funny. That sounds great. It's a plan. Cool. Ustedes recuerdan quiénes dijeron estas frases. Bueno, se dijeron en esa conversación. Les voy a dar un segundito para que, bueno, las lean y vean, porque estas son frases que yo quiero que ustedes copien y recuerden para el momento en que tengan que, dramatizar o escenificar una situación similar a esta. Aquí yo los estoy ayudando a que identifiquen en la conversación qué muchacha dijo cada una de estas expresiones. Estas son, expresiones que contribuyen a mantener la fluidez y la coherencia en la comunicación. Y que en el transcurso de este semestre, pues bueno, o de este curso, iremos trabajando para que ustedes aprendan a mantener una comunicación fluida, una comunicación natural, porque estas frases ayudan a eso. Because this is great. Learning English is cool. Así dirían los jóvenes. Eso está suave, dirían los jóvenes cubanos. Y en inglés, entonces decimos, this is cool. Is English cool for you? I hope so. Well, this is all for today. And well, we need to say goodbye. Enjoy the rest of the day.